Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about how not to put your subwoofer on the floor. I see it all the time, I see it in corners. Be careful here, this is a huge energy producing source. Not only it produces energy, but it produces low frequency energy, which is very difficult to deal with in today's small rooms and volume. So what kind of energy does it produce? Well, it's got a huge driver in it that's moving back and forth, right? So this piston-like quality of the diaphragm moving creates all kinds of vibrations, creates all kinds of energy through the cabinet in all directions. So we have this vibration, which couples directly with the floor. If you set it on the floor, then obviously we have the pressure generated from the subwoofer itself. So we need to address the vibrations to the floor first, so we decouple the subwoofer. Now there's spikes and all kinds of other things, but I'm going to propose something else, that works a little bit better. We have to isolate from the floor with our speaker cabinet, correct? Okay, because we want to minimize the transmission of noise or vibration, if you will, to the floor itself. So we put a structure underneath it. This elevates it, let's say 12 inches off the floor. And if we make this a diaphragmatic absorber, we also can locate pressure-activated absorption closest to the source. I mean, the subwoofer sitting on it. And we have platforms on our site where you can look and do that. So we use diaphragmatic absorption as the platform itself, which minimizes the transmission of noise, decouples the subwoofer from the floor, but more importantly, adds a huge amount of absorption right at the source. So that's critical when you're dealing with subwoofer energy, which is radiated from all sides of a subwoofer, not just out of the front. So another thing we have to realize, it is a huge pressure device, okay? So if we put everything on the floor of our room, we have a home theater situation, we have all our subwoofers on the floor of a room, we're pressurizing a big part of the room coupled to the actual structure itself. But in order to get a smoother frequency response, we need to raise the height of these subwoofers within our room so that they're not all the same. This is what we found. In our studio, we have them at 12 inches off the floor. We have some that are 18, and we have some that are even 24. And what this uneven distance does is it balances out the pressure fields within the room better. If you have it all on the one plane down here, the pressure and the floor combination can give you more room sound. So if you elevate them, put them in unequal distances, and then obviously you have to locate where they are, where they're going to be within the room itself. And that's depending on size and total volume. So you have to look at all those variables. But the nice thing about decoupling the subwoofer from the floor is that you can use diaphragmatic absorption and absorb energy right at the source, and decouple it also, so you minimize noise transmission also. And then if you raise the platforms at different heights, you balance out the pressure distribution within the sound fields in the room. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.